Mr. Chancellor, Mr. Foreign Minister, Mr. Secretary of State, it is with the greatest pleasure that I bid you welcome to the United States and to my home state of Texas. As a good friend, a great European, and as Chancellor of the Federal Republic of Germany, you have come to a part of our country where there are many Americans whose forebears came from Germany. So while all of us are your friends, there are many who feel a very personal relationship and who look forward to meeting you. We shall be working hard while you are here, but there will also be time to meet some of our neighbors, to see us as we are, and to join us in a Texas barbecue. It is our duty in these next 2 days to discuss the great tasks of the future. It is our good fortune to build on the work of great men who have gone before, to begin our labor together in a time when historic dangers have been turned back and hope for the future of freedom has been strengthened. So in that spirit, Mr. Chancellor, we meet today. We have much to do to strengthen the forces of freedom, to reinforce the Atlantic partnership, to increase our cooperation with all free nations, new and old, and to enlarge the prospect of peace everywhere. In all that we do, we shall act together as the leaders of two free peoples who have proved their friendship with each other in trial and in triumph. So, Mr. Chancellor, once more let me tell you how happy all Americans are to have you here, and what a very special pleasure it will be for Mrs. Johnson and me to have you as our guests at our home.
Herr President.
Mr. President, Mr. Secretary of State, thank you from the bottom of my heart for the most friendly welcome which you have accorded me here today. My party and I consider it as a privilege during those quiet days of Christmas to be with you in order to follow the message of Christmas and to do everything in our power to deepen and to enlarge the peace all over the world. That is our task. During those last 18 years, the friendship between our two peoples, and in fact between the statesmen of our two peoples, has grown ever more and become deeper and deeper. More and more we have realized that there are common tasks for us. More and more we have felt that our fate is a common one. And we in Germany know that peace and freedom are indivisible. They are not only indivisible insofar as the fierce spheres of life of the individual peoples are concerned, but peace and freedom are indivisible insofar as the cohesion of the free world altogether is concerned. You, Mr. President, in one of the darkest and most worrisome hours, have given hope and courage and confidence to the people of Berlin. And this deed, Mr. President, will never be forgotten. In the same way as the hearts of the Berliners opened up to the late President Kennedy. We, too, in some way, are starting our work from the same position. We are called upon to carry on a great heritage and to fructify that heritage. That is the sense of this meeting, that we, you, Mr. President, and I myself, should come into close human contact so as to have the confidence which exists between our two peoples deeply rooted in our two persons. Again, Mr. President, let me tell you all the satisfaction and pleasure which I feel that we have so soon an opportunity of meeting, and the hope which I have that this meeting will be a fruitful one.